Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-21 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is a load of 5 kN is applied to the center of A992 steel beam for which moment of inertia is 4.5 into 10 to the power 6 mm power 4. If beam is supported by two springs, each having stiffness of K 8 mega Newton per meter, determine the strain energy in each of the spring and the bending strain energy in this beam. So you can see this is the beam that is supported on this two spring having stiffness K is 8 mega Newton per meter and there is a 5 kilonewton load applied at the mid. So due to this load, you have to determine the strain energy in the beam due to bending and the strain energy in each of the springs. So let's start with the solution. So first we know that strain energy due to bending is equal to integral of m square dx divided by 2EI and limit will be from 0 to L. So we'll find the moment for this, but before moment, if you remove this spring K, so this spring will exert a vertical reaction on this which will be equal to P of spring, and similarly if you remove this spring will exert vertical reaction on this beam which is also PS. Like this is your point 1 and this is your point 2. So we'll find this PS by using this equation of equilibrium. Both spring are same and same stiffness, so PS is equal to, let PS is equal to P, clear? So we will find this by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see P of steel plus P of steel, spring, sorry, not steel, minus 5 is equal to 0. So 2 times P of spring is equal to 5 and P of spring will be equal to 5 divided by 2, which gives you force exerted by spring on this beam will be equal to 2.5 kN. So each spring exert 2.5 kN on this beam. Now what we will do is that we will cut this beam at any length. For example, this length is X and we will draw the free body diagram to find the equation of movement. So you can see here this is 2.5 kN. This is your point 1. 2.5 and kilo is 10 to the power 3 newton. This is the total length X, clear? And when you cut it, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a moment as well. Let this is point O, clear? So we will find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point O is equal to zero and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point O, one moment is this counterclockwise, which is reaction moment, so it is plus. And the second moment is due to this load, 2.5 kN and perpendicular distance is X and this is producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So minus 2.5 into 10 to the power 3 time X is equal to 0. So it means that moment is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power 3 times X, clear? So this is the moment equation, but here X will be for X is greater or equal to 0 and less or equal to 3 meter. Why? Because at 3 meter you can see you have 5 kilonewton load. So what we will do is that we will take one half portion is this one and another half portion this one. Now we will apply this equation. So here you can see strain energy due to bending for this condition, or this loading, or this loading X greater than 0 and less or equal to 3, clear? You can see you have two portion, one is this one and another one is for this one. So I will write 2 multiply by integral of 0 to L m square dx divided by 2EI. Okay, so you can just put the value 2 into integral of 0 to L, m value of m is 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 3 times x square dx divided by 2ei. Clear? So 2 will cancel with this. So we will left with 1 over ei, and that will be from 0 to L 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 3 whole square into x square dx. So you can take this constant out of the integral. So you will get 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 3 whole square divided by ei, and you will left with integral from 0 to L, and here this will be equal to from 0 to 3, and we have x square into dx. So if you further simplify, this will be the same ei, and we will get integral x cube divided by 3, and limit will be from 0 to 3. Okay, now you can put the limits divided by ei into x is 3 cube. So 3 cube minus 0 cube divided by 3. And if you put the value of I is also given. You can see the value of I is 4.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Given is that. So you have to convert it into meter power 4. So that will be 4.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. So I will write 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 3 whole square divided by I value was 4.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 multiply by 3 cube divided by 3. And what about E? E for A992. So you have to go to the property table in the book. So here I have mentioned in the yellow color, you can see this is average mechanical property of material, and from yellow this is 200 gigapascal. So you have to write this from here. So 200 into 10 raised to the power 9 pascal. This will be the strain energy due to bending. And when you solve this, you will get the strain energy due to bending will come out to be 62.5 joules. So this is the answer of our first part, which is to determine the bending strain energy in the beam. Now we'll find the bending strain energy in the spring. So you can see this load, the spring applies a load on this beam. As a result, this beam will also apply the same force on the spring, that is compression. So we know that P of spring is equal to 2.5 kilonewton. Stiffness of spring is given as 8 mega newton per meter, which is equal to 8 into 10 to the power 6 newton per meter. So we know that deflection in spring is equal to P of spring divided by K of spring, because P of spring is equal to K of spring into deflection of spring. So from here we will get this equation. So now put the value 2.5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 8 into 10 raised to the power 6, that will give you 0.3125 into 10 raised to the power minus 3, and unit will be meter. So this will be the deflection of spring. Now strain energy due to in spring is equal to, as this spring is in compression, so strain energy in spring due to compression will be equal to 1 over 2. This is the formula, K into deflection of spring square. So just put the value, you will get strain energy in spring due to compression will be equal to 1 over 2. K is 8 into 10 raised to the power 6 multiplied by 0.3125 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 whole square. So when you multiply this, you will get 0.391 joule, which is the strain energy in spring due to compression. So this is the amount of strain energy that will be stored in each spring due to applied loading on the beam. And that was all about this simple problem 11-21. 14-21. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you are learning from my videos as well. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. Also share my videos in your circle and help me in growing further as well as help other people in learning. Thank you for watching.